Today we will discuss about first order reaction of lesson chemical kinetics. In last video we came to know about the zero order reaction. Same manner में इसे भी start करते हैं. What means first order reaction? First order reactions are those in which ROR depend upon first power of concentration of reactant. It means what? We can say rate equals to K R to the power 1 like this. Again, I tell you what means first order reaction. ROR depend upon the first power of the concentration of reactant. And again, we can write both differential rate equation and according to RLE. We can write rate according to both. Likewise, if I say it is a first order reaction kinetics at T0, reactant concentration known as initial concentration and product will be zero, and at time t concentration of reactant, sum of the concentration of reactant will convert into the product, and r is the remained concentration after time t. R naught is the initial concentration of reactant, r is the concentration of reactant after time t. That's clear. Now differential rate equation. According to differential rate equation, rate is equals to minus dr over dt. It means what? Decrease in concentration of reactant. Ye with respect to reactant likha hua hai. And according to RLE, rate law expression, rate is equals to K r to the power 1. Now, both are the formulas of rate. We can equalize both. Equalize both. Minus dr over dt equals to kr like this. I can write this form in this also. Concentration of reactant at left hand side and constant and change in time right hand side like this. And I also change the position of the sign. Okay, तो ये फॉर्म सिर्फ चेंज किया है. नाउ इंटीग्रेटिंग बोथ साइड, इफ वी इंटीग्रेट दिस इक्वेशन डी आर ओवर आर गिव्स आउट माइनस के डी टी लाइक दिस. अब व्हाट इज द वैल्यू ऑफ दिस वन? इफ आई इंटीग्रेट dx over x, its value comes out to be ln x. Okay, if I integrate variable dx over x, its value comes out to be ln x, matlab log base ex. Same while if we integrate dr over r, it comes out to be ln r. And limits are, initial limit is r naught and final limit is r, right? So hum isko likh dete hain ln r, and now we put limits, initial limits and final limit like this. Again minus and constant comes out to be outside. Integrating to differentiation cancel out, and time ke liye initial limit 0, final limit t like this, right? Now what? Final limit minus initial limit, it means ln r minus ln r naught gives out minus kt. What would be here? Minus k, t minus 0, and t minus 0 comes out to be t. Now formula becomes ln r minus ln r naught equals to minus kt, and it can be write in this form also, ln r equals to minus kt plus ln r naught. It is a straight line equation. And it is also known as integrating rate law for the first order. Okay. Now, I can write this formula in some other manner also. How? Kt. If I put kt to the left hand side and ln r naught over r like this. Can I write this formula in this form also? It is formula number 1, formula number 2. From formula number 1. From formula 1. Because first order reaction has so many formulas and question can be put up by any of the formula. You must know each and every formula. If you find one formula, you can derive another formulas also, right? So if I know this one formula, I can derive another formulas also like this. Formula number 2, derived from the first. Next formula also derived from the first. Uske baad bhi next, we will also derive from these formulas. Look at this from formula 1. If I convert log base e into log base 10, what I have to do? I have to multiply it by 2.303. You must remember, if I want to change ln to log base 10, ln is also known as log base e. ओके मैं यहाँ पर एक नोट बना करके लिख देती हूँ. इट्स अ नोट. ln आल्सो नोन एज लॉग बेस ई एंड इफ आई वांट टू चेंज लॉग बेस ई टू लॉग बेस 10 आई हैव टू मल्टीप्लाइड बाय 2.303 इनटू लॉग बेस 10. राइट नाउ लॉग बेस ई को अगर मुझे लॉग बेस 10 में कन्वर्ट करना है, व्हाट आई हैव टू डू, आई विल मल्टीप्लाई इट बाय 2.303. नाउ आई विल डू सेम. लुक एट दिस, 2.303 लॉग बेस 10 आर लाइक दिस इक्वल्स टू माइनस के टी प्लस 2.303 लॉग बेस 10 आर नॉट. Now, formula number 1 converted into this form. If I divide this formula, whole formula, by 2.303 like this. Now, this becomes what? Log base 10 r equals to minus kt over 2.303 plus log base 10 r naught. Now look at this. This is the formula number 3. And very important. Okay. Look. This formula changes into this form. Now formula 1. From formula 1. I can write this formula into this form. This formula into this form. Now from formula 3, I have to see the relation between the rate constant and concentration with respect to time. Look, kt over 2.303 equals to log base 10 r naught over r. This form and this form are identical, means formula 2 and formula 4 are identical. Formula 2 for the ln form and formula 4 for the log form. Okay. Now what? K. K equals to 2.303 over T log base 10 R naught over R. And it is very important formula. Most of the numerical problems will be solved with the help of this formula. You must remember this formula very well. Now, what is R naught? R naught is initial concentration. Initial concentration of reactant. What is R? R is remained concentration of reactant after T time. Means what is the concentration of reactant remain after T time? Let's suppose I tell you 60% reaction complete. What it means? If I want to say what is R naught. R naught would be 100. I am saying 60% reaction complete. The initial amount was 100. Let's suppose 100. And if 60% complete, it means out of 100, 60 part completed into the product. What remain? 40. Okay, so what is R? R is the concentration of reactant remain after time T. You don't confuse in this case. Okay, now come to the next form. Again, I will use formula number this one. Formula number 2 from formula 2. KT equals to ln R naught over R. Can I write it in this form also? ln R over R naught. Let's suppose मैंने इन्हें inverse कर दिया, तो I have to put sign minus KT like this. If I want to remove log base E, तो मुझे anti-log लेना होगा. I have to apply anti-log both side. If I want to cancel this ln, I have to take anti-log. If I take anti-log, what will happen? Ln will be cancelled out. Taking anti-log both side. If I take anti-log, it comes out to be what? R over R naught equals to e to the power minus kt. And it becomes e to the power. Okay. Now what? R is what? R naught e to the power minus kt. From here, what can you say? Can you say something? E means what? Exponentially. Concentration of reactant exponentially decrease with time. Right? From this formula, what can you say? Concentration of reactant. Concentration of reactant decrease exponentially with time. Again, very very important. Now half lifetime. The half, I discussed it in zero order also. What means half lifetime? The time period in which concentration, or you can say half of the concentration of reactant converted into the product. Or you can say in short the time in which initial concentration of reactant reduced to half. Right? Now, at half lifetime, T is replaced by T half and R becomes what? Half of the initial concentration. Definition you know according to the zero order kinetics. And now I tell you only derivation for the half-life time in first order. So T becomes T half and R, concentration of R becomes what? After half time, it remains half of the initial concentration. Now put these two in formula number this one. If I say 5, right? Formula is what? K equals to, अब मैं क्या करती हूँ, T को लेफ्ट हैंड साइड ले लेते हैं, T half 2.303 over K log base 10 R naught over R की जगह पुट करना है R naught by 2. That's clear. Now it becomes what? T half equals to 2.303 over K. R naught to R naught cancel and 2 becomes numerator. Log base 10 2. And log base 10 2 ki value hoti hai 0.3010. Put kar dete hain, T half become 2.303 into 0.3010 over K. It comes out to be 0.693 over K. Another formula. Again, very very important formula. For first order kinetics, this formula is very very important. Sometime what happens? T half is given and you have to find out order of reaction like this. So if T half is given, you can find out rate constant and whatever asked in the question, you can calculate. Right? Now next is time period or lifetime. 100%. I am taking all the topics according to the zero order. As I take in the zero order one by one, तो same manner है. In this also I am taking the same manner. Lifetime means what? Whole the reactant completed into the product. Is it possible for the first order reaction? Look at this. If lifetime is completed, it means whole the reactant is converted into the product. At that time you will put T as a T 100% or T lifetime LT, like this. And in this case, concentration of reactant becomes zero. Now look at this. If I put this value in formula number 5, like this, T 100% equals to 2.303 over K log base 10 R naught over 0. Or I can write in this formula also, ln T 100% equals to, if I take 1 by K, ln R naught by 0. I can put in both formulas, and ln 0 value is infinity. You must know ln 0 equals to what? Infinity. If ln 0 is infinity, it means if I put here, this reaction will not be completed any time. Okay, the first order reaction never completed. Again, very important point, first order reactions never completed. They goes on regularly. For example, radioactive decay. Radioactive decay is the radioactive substance get dissociated into smaller and smaller and smaller molecules, but smaller nuclei, but it can't be finished. Or you can say reactant can't be completely converted into the product. So it follow first order reaction never completed. Why never completed? वो मैंने भी आपको बता दिया है. Now come to the graph sections. And one more thing, what you have to remember in case of T half do not depend upon initial concentration. Of reactant, as in case of zero order, you have seen T half depend upon the initial concentration of reactant. Formula kya hai tha? T half equals to R naught by 2K. But in this case, T half independent on the initial concentration of the reactant. Why I tell you about it? Because it will come, yeah, it will be followed into the graph. That why I tell you about this. Now we will discuss about the graphs in the first order reaction. First is, we know that rate equals to K R to the power 1. It means rate depend upon the concentration of the reactant, right? If it depend upon the concentration of reactant, what would be its graph? Rate and concentration. It would be a straight line graph and like this. Okay, now next. I know about the integrated rate law for the first order, ln R equals to minus KT plus ln R naught. It is Y is equals to MX plus C type reaction. It means straight line equation. If we plot graph, it comes out to be like this. Y axis ln R on X axis time. Here time is 0 and slope is minus K. I tell you, first order reaction never completed. That's why I don't match it to the timeline. It's mean lifetime. Okay. And its intercept, it would be equals to ln R naught. This is graph for this formula. I can apply or I can write another form of this formula, log base 10 r equals to minus kt over 2.303 plus log base 10 r naught. Now formula for, now graph for this, again this is y equals to mx plus c type equation, and graph again straight line graph like this. Okay, on y axis log base 10 r, on x axis time intercept log base 10 r naught, and slope equals to minus k over 2.303. It is again very very important, in any form graph can be asked. Next, one more formula I have tell you, log r naught over r equals to kt by 2.303, or I can write ln r naught by r equals to kt. Okay, same. Now I would like to plot a graph between log r naught by r and t. So it would be a straight line graph like this, with a slope equals to k over 2.303. Hopefully all the students will be able to plot graph with the help of formula. And in this case, this is very simple and very easy equation. If you know the integrated rate law equation for the first order, you can derive all the formulas and you can plot all the graphs. And with the help of graphs, we can solve all the problems given in the question paper, right? Now, T half. We know that for the first order reaction, T half is independent on the concentration of the reactant, like this. It don't depend upon the initial concentration or concentration of reactant. Now plot. If we plot a graph, T half and concentration of reactant, it comes out to be like this. Because half-life time for the first order reaction do not depend upon the concentration of reactant. That's why graph would be like this. Now next topic is examples. First example is, we know H2O2 aqueous solution is unstable. And if it is unstable, it get dissociated into like this. H2O2 dissociated into H2O and half of O2. Why? Because this is unstable and this reaction follow first order kinetics like this. Rate equals to K H2O2 to the power 1. Next example is all the natural and artificial radioactive decay. I tell you now, all artificial and natural decay of radioactive element. जितने भी रेडियो एक्टिव एलिमेंट्स हैं उनका नेचुरल या फिर आर्टिफिशियली, मतलब आर्टिफिशियल है या नेचुरल है, उनका डिके ये सब फॉलो करता है फर्स्ट ऑर्डर काइनेटिक्स. नेक्स्ट एग्जांपल इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट एंड वेरी कॉमन रिएक्शन, डीकम्पोजिशन ऑफ N2O5. इट गेट डिसोशिएटेड इनटू NO2 एंड O2. बैलेंस कर लेते हैं लाइक दिस, एंड इट ऑल्सो फॉलो फर्स्ट ऑर्डर काइनेटिक्स. Rate equals to K N2O5 to the power 1. Next example, growth or decay of bacteria in sample. Just like जब curd formation होता है, in this case also bacteria डेवलप होते हैं. तो ग्रोथ एंड डिके ऑफ बैक्टीरिया इन अ सैंपल. वन मोर एग्जाम्पल आई वॉन्ट टू टेल यू, हाइड्रोजिनेशन ऑफ इथीन. There are so many examples which follow first order kinetics. I give you few important and main example like this. You must remember these examples. You must remember how the reactions follow the first order kinetics. Now we will take one overview again. Whatever I studied right now, first order reaction is what? Which follows first order kinetics. Its mean order will be 1, and we can write differential rate equation and RLE both for a given reaction, and we can equalize. When we equalize and integrate, then we get this form, ln R equals to minus KT plus ln R naught. It is known as what? It is known as integrating rate law equation for the first order, and it is again a straight line equation. This formula can be written in this form. Again, this formula, this is in the form of log base E. I can convert it into the log base 10 by multiplying 2.303, and this form is now changed into this one. And from this formula, I can find out this formula, and this formula is very, very important. Most of the problems will be solved with the help of this formula. I am saying most of the problem, right? What is R naught? R naught is the initial concentration, and R is the, remember that during the solving problem, yahan par confusion ho jata hai. R is the concentration of reactant remained after time T. Okay, now next, जैसे मैंने अभी यहाँ पर बताया 60% रिएक्शन कंप्लीट मींस व्हाट वॉट रिमेन 40. ओके, नाउ फॉर्मूला, फॉर्मूला नंबर 2 को ही हमने चेंज किया इन दिस फॉर्म. के टी इक्वल्स टू एल एन आर नॉट ओवर आर. व्हाट कैन आई डू? एल एन आर ओवर आर नॉट. इफ आई चेंज द डिनोमिनेटर टू न्यूमरेटर एंड न्यूमरेटर टू डिनोमिनेटर, आई हैव टू पुट साइन negative minus kt, and taking anti-log because I want to change, I want to remove ln log base e, so I have to take anti-log. When I take anti-log, so either e ki power lena hoga, and now formula becomes r equals to r naught e to the power minus kt. This is showing exponential graph, right? It means with time, concentration of reactant decreases exponentially. Concentration of reactant decrease exponentially with time. Half-life time period, half-life time ka matlab, the time period in which concentration of reactant remain half, and formula comes out to be 0.693 over K, and this indicate T half do not depend upon the initial concentration of reactant. Okay, now lifetime, these reactions can't be completed, and in this case we follow first order reaction never completed, and then graphs for the rate and the concentration graph, straight line graph for these integrated rate law equations, and again graph for this log R naught over R equals to KT over 2.303, and the graph for the T half and the concentration, initial concentration ke independent hai. You can plot any graph, and then example, all those examples which follow first order kinetics means H2O2, decomposition of H2O2 in aqueous solution, it is unstable and decomposes. Artificial and natural radioactive substances, again they get decomposes by the first order reaction kinetics. N2O5 decomposition, it also follow first order kinetics. Bacteria growth in sample, first order kinetics. Hydrogenation reactions, वो भी फर्स्ट ऑर्डर काइनेटिक्स फॉलो करती हैं. इन नेक्स्ट वीडियो वी केम टू नो अबाउट द स्यूडो फर्स्ट ऑर्डर रिएक्शन. टिल देन गुड बाय.